Then the priest came. Yes, he has given 100,000. Do you know the place of worship in our, I cannot see, church or temple, I cannot use the word, the leaking, I spent 30,000 to repair the roof. The balance I put. Then the lawyer came. You know, lawyers are very honest people. You know? They never bluff me. Lawyer came and scolded both of them. You have disappointed this poor man. Don't worry. I am going to replace what they have spent. And my 100,000 and what they have spent, he issued account pay cash check. Put in the copy. And same thing will happen to you also if you believe that you get something hereafter, anything put in the coffin. You know, Chinese are very clever people. They are the only people who could manage to open a bank in the hell. Americans who have landed on the moon still could not open a bank in the hell. So, my dear friend, Buddhism is to open our mind to understand. Why Chinese wanted to learn Buddhism? Because more than 5,000 years old culture, philosophy, they had in China. Ancient culture, human culture on this earth. During Confucius period, that is only 80 years after the Buddha, Confucius lived. And Lao Tzu, 30 years after the Buddha. So they approach Confucius and ask, is there any life again after our death? Confucius said, still we have not learned what this life is. How do we know whether there will be another life? So they could not satisfy with that. Another group came and asked, is there anything that we can do for our departed ones? Confucius said, still we have not learned how to fulfill our duty to living one. What can we do for the dead one? That is why they have decided to go to India. 2,000 years ago, they have taken so much of troubles and pains. Do you know the going from China to India at that time by crossings and rivers and deserts and jungles and such a long period. If 50 people started, maybe 20 people reached there, others die on the way. But they had courage. After going there, they studied. They observe very carefully how they practice religion. Because there were three religions very active. Hinduism, Jainism, and Buddhism. Observe very carefully how they practice these three religions. Then they noticed, to practice Hinduism or Jainism, they must follow Indian tradition, Indian custom, Indian way of life. Otherwise, they cannot practice. But to practice Buddhism, it is not necessary to follow Indian tradition. That means Chinese knew it is not necessary for Chinese to become Indian to practice Buddhism. They learned only Buddhism, gone back and introduced without any difficulty in China. Chinese culture and Buddhism combined together. No difficulty. But other religions, no one can practice in this way. Now, if you become the follower of another religion tomorrow, there are many things you have to give up. They say, cannot. According to our religion, you cannot eat this, you cannot go there, you cannot do this. But if others come and join into Buddhism, there is nothing to change. If they are not doing any wicked and cruel and immoral things, nothing else for them to change. That means the Buddha has given due credit to culture and tradition. He mentioned in one of his discourses, Kalama Sutra, he said, if your culture and traditions are meaningful, significant, don't think these are age-old traditions, follow them. If they are meaningless, useless, don't follow them thinking this is our own tradition. This is the advice given by the Buddha. So Chinese, let us take Malaysia. Up to 14th century, here, Malaya, only two religions, Buddhism and Hinduism. When the chief of Malacca, I heard he was a Hindu, embraced Islam.